Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm gonna do EMG frequency analysis. Especially I'm gonna talk about FFT, fast Fourier transform, mean median analysis, frequency analysis, and STFT, which is short time Fourier transform. Goal of this YouTube video is to make this plot. This is FFT, x-axis is frequency and the y-axis is amplitude. So like I showed you in my previous video, I did amplitude analysis. X-axis was time in second or millisecond, but this time x-axis is frequency in hertz. And after that, I'm gonna show you how to do mean frequency analysis. So basically, based on the plot I showed you in the previous plot, I'm gonna find the mean frequency and the bar plot. So as you can see, the first group of bars trial 1, and you can say trial 2, trial 3, trial 4, trial 5, and y-axis is frequency in hertz, and median frequency analysis. So principle is the same, this time median instead of mean. Then I'm gonna go a little bit further. So I think this should be frequency in y-axis. I did this analysis in impulse in my previous video, so I'm so sorry. This y-axis should be frequency, but as you can see, the first group of bars are 20% of entire EMG, and 50% of entire EMG, and 80% of EMG analysis, and each bar represents each trial, and all bars are EMG of right bicep femoris. So the last plot is STFT, short time Fourier transform. So as you saw the previous plot, you didn't see time component in the plot, because if you do FFT, you actually lose time component. But if you do STFT, you can include time component, and yeah, basically you can see frequency component, time component, and the amplitude or power component as the same plot. So that's the STFT procedure. So first of all, I'm gonna do pre-processing, then timing analysis. So I made videos to do pre-processing and timing analysis, so if you don't know how to do that, please check my previous videos. Then after that, I'm gonna conduct FFT, which is fast Fourier transform. Then I'm gonna find the mean frequency, median frequency. Then I'm gonna perform short time Fourier transform. I'm gonna show you how to do those all procedures by using Matlab. So let's go to Matlab. Okay, Matlab. So first of all, I'm gonna import data. Yes, this is raw data. I showed you raw data in my previous videos. So just check my previous video and you see the raw data. And I'm just gonna run this line, which is just the name of the muscles. Then I'm gonna run this to detrend the raw data, and I'm gonna filter the data. It's a bandpass filter, and the cutoff frequency is 10 and 500. Then by using filter data, I'm gonna do TKO. This is timing analysis, so if you don't know how to do it, just go check my previous video. Then I'm gonna find the muscle on and the muscle off by using TKO. This procedure is not really based on research paper, this is just adjusted for this particular EMG. So I'm gonna run this. And based on muscle on and the muscle off, I'm gonna find the muscle activity duration. You just subtract muscle off from muscle on. I'm just gonna run this line and find the duration. Then from here, I'm gonna start frequency analysis. So first of all, I'm gonna conduct FFT. So function I'm gonna use is FFT, which is right here. Input argument is filter data, and I'm gonna define the muscle activation by using on and off, and the FFT function returns just one vector value based on this filter data right here. And I'm gonna rectify the output value from FFT basically, and save all values into variable called P2. This is double-sided, which means you will see frequency in left side and right side. It's like a mirrored. I mean, basically left side and right side is the same as positive value and negative value. And like I said in my previous video, in EMG, amplitude in positive and amplitude in negative are the same, basically. So you rectify the data and make it all positive, but still you have frequency on left side and right side. Maybe I can show you what I mean. Okay, so this is one-sided FFT. So if I don't transform, you see this double-sided. Sorry, x-axis is just messed up, but like basically this is double-sided. Left side and right side are pretty much same, but I only need either side basically. But like just choose left side. I mean it's easier. So I only need half of this data. Then this line P1 just create half of P2 by specifying the data in P2 from 1 to whatever it's half length y divided by 2, and I put plus 1 right here because the data actually starts from 1 frequency. So if you, let's see this one, x-axis is kind of messed up, but like hopefully we can see what I mean. Yeah, so x-axis messed up, but like 0 is actually right here, but like it starts from 1. Frequency should start from 0. So that's why I extract one extra value, and when I define the x-axis by using this formula, frequency, I'm gonna have same dimension in x-axis and y-axis, because later on I'm gonna plot frequency in x-axis and amplitude in y-axis, because this FFT, the y is pretty much the y-axis amplitude. Then I'm gonna define x-axis in separate variable. I mean, you can plot only with this y, but then x-axis is not frequency, it's like a pin, like histogram. So this line convert bins to hertz, which is frequency. So the formula is simple. So the length of the EMG, which is from 0, not from 1, 0 to, I mean, whatever half of the length, because I converted double-sided FFT to single-sided FFT. So I just need half of it. Then multiply it by frequency, which is 2000, because I use the 2000 sample frequencies with this EMG, so times frequency and divided by the length of EMG data. Then this is x-axis frequency, and the P1 is y-axis, which is amplitude. Then you get this one-sided FFT. And if you take a look at the plot, as you can see, it's starting from 0, not from 1. So that's what I did in this code right here, and you just plot and enhance the plot by using X label or subtitle. And I explained this code in my previous video, so if you wanna know what this means, you just go check my previous video. Then this plot is muscle by muscle. So this is trial, this is bicep femoris, right semitendinosus, and the left side. But this line is just trial by trial, which is one muscle in trial 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So basically the same plot, but it's just a different context. Then after FFT, I'm gonna conduct mean frequency analysis. So I'm gonna use function called mean freq. You just put input argument, which is just filter data, and I defined the duration from muscle on to muscle off, and the second input argument is frequency, which is 2000. Then mean freq function finds mean frequency muscle by muscle and trial by trial. So I'm gonna show you the plot and you will see what I mean. Okay, so this is the mean frequency of this EMG plot, and yes, I think this is valid. I mean, I think this is correct. I mean, mean value is like around, yeah, here, here. And this is trial 1, and the first muscle is right bicep femoris, right semi tendon nodus on the left side, and this is second trial, third trial, fourth trial, and so on. Then I created a bar plot, just showing the all mean frequencies, muscle by muscle, and trial by trial, and the same plot. Okay, so this is a plot I showed you in my presentation slide. Y-axis is frequency, and x-axis is the trial. So as you can see, mean frequency of right semitendinosus is always the highest, and the second highest is right bicep femoris. I mean, in the first trial, left bicep femoris is kind of same as right bicep femoris, but in general, right bicep femoris is the second, left bicep femoris is the third, and left semitendinosus is the fourth. So I think I told you in my previous amplitude analysis video, you can't really compare one muscle with another muscle or one trial with another trial without normalization. So what you can do is find a pattern across trials maybe. Then this is just the pattern I found for now. Maybe you can find something else. And the medium frequency analysis is kind of same, but I'm gonna use median instead of mean. So function is called met freak, not mean freak, and the input argument is same. So let's run this and let's see the plot. I mean, plot is the same, but this time is median. So I'm gonna show you the bar plot instead of the plot with FFT EMG. Okay, so this is bar plot on median frequency analysis. X-axis is same, y-axis is same, and I can see kind of same pattern as mean frequency, but frequency is little bit different because this is 120 here, but this is 100. So I think mean frequency overestimate the frequency compared to median frequency analysis. And you can use either one, but you have to stick to one analysis. So that's a median frequency analysis. And I did little bit further. So I did this in my previous video, which is about amplitude analysis. And I found the amplitude in 20% of entire EMG, and 50% and 80%. And I'm gonna do the same thing with median frequency, not amplitude. So the code is same, variable is just changed, or function is changed, but principle is the same. So if you don't know what this code means, or what this function means, or like what I just did in this line or that line, just go back to my previous video and I explained kind of everything. So for now, I'm just gonna run this, and I'm just gonna show you one plot, which is about right bicep femoris. So this is 20% of entire FFT EMG, and this is 50%, and this is 80%. Okay, I have to change y-axis. I'm sorry, this is impulse, because like I said, I did kind of same analysis in amplitude analysis, and the y-axis is impulse, but like this time y-axis should be frequency. But yeah, I have to change this one, but I cannot really find the pattern from 20% to 50% or 50% to 80%. So maybe you can find something else, but as far as I observe the plot, I cannot find anything. So that was right bicep femoris, and the second plot is about right semitendinosus, and you can do the same thing for the left leg. So basically we can go to the next analysis or next step, which is STFT, short time Fourier transform. So Matlab makes it very very easy. You just put the function right here, it's called spectrogram, and you just put input argument, which is filter data, and I defined filter data from muscle on to muscle off right here, and this is the first input argument, and the second input argument I put like default. So if you wanna just use default value in the second input argument, you just use square bracket, and third input argument, fourth input argument, fifth input argument, I put 2000 because this EMG, I used 2000 sample frequencies. So I just put 2000 right here. And you don't really have to put y-axis argument. It just rotates the axis. So frequency should be in y-axis instead of x-axis. If you wanna use default, you just remove this and the frequency moves to x-axis. So I'm just gonna run this and you will see what I mean. Okay, so this is a spectrogram and this is trial one. So like I said, y-axis is frequency and x-axis is time. So in the previous plot, I showed you like FFT, you didn't see the time component, but this time you see frequency, time, and amplitude component by color. I mean, you can rotate this plot because this is 3D, and you can do it like this. It's 3D plot. So this is STFT pretty much, and I'm gonna explain the input argument. Okay, so second input argument, which is this one, is time window. You can watch other YouTube videos and they explain how STFT works really good. So if you wanna know the details about window component, you just watch those videos and yeah, you will understand really fine. So you can manipulate time window here. And the third input argument is overlap of time window. So if you want to define FFT in, let's say, 1 second, you're gonna put 1 second right here. I mean, it totally depends on what sample frequencies you have. So for this time, like a 2000, if you wanna do 1 second time window, you're gonna put 2000 right here. And if you wanna have overlap, let's say 1/2 second, you're gonna put 1000 right here. So you're gonna do FFT in 1 second, and you're gonna move 1/2 second. So there is a 1/2 second overlap, and do the same thing. You move 1/2 second, you do again FFT, then so on and so on until the end. So that's the third argument. Fourth argument is frequency wise. So you're gonna find the resolution of frequency. I mean, there is no universal value, you have to play around. So that's why I put the default right here. I mean, I'm gonna put this code on my blog and you can play around with this number. I can show you the big plot with this one, and I put 1000 for time window and 100 data point overlap, and the frequency resolution is default, and I put 2000 on the y-axis, and yes, like this. So pretty much it's really tough to see the resolution, so I'm gonna change the view. So this view function can rotate the plot basically. So okay, so this is plot and the time resolution is 1000. I'm gonna show you the default first of all. So I'm gonna put square bracket right here, square bracket, and this is default value, and like this. So time resolution is only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 pins right now, but like the previous one, I put the 1000 time window, then you will see more bins right here and 100 overlap, I guess. And the frequency is already tiny resolution, I would say, but like you can play around. Maybe you put, I don't know, 10 for example, it changed like this. So yes, obviously the bins are like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, just really low resolution, I would say, I mean compared to this. So you can play around with this value and you can find, I don't know, best value for this EMG data, but I'm just gonna leave it there. Maybe you can find something better than mine, so then please let me know the value. Okay, so pretty much it. Thank you for watching my video, and maybe next time I'm gonna show you how to do normalization. So see you next time.